So here we're going to look at using multiple repeats. Right now I've made something with repeat 4, and it plays the note 60, that's middle C, and then it plays the drum 1, which is a snare drum. Let's listen. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put another repeat around that repeat. And I'm going to have this repeat twice. So what'll happen is I'll repeat the whole inside of that repeat 2 twice. The inside of that repeat 2 plays each of these 4 times, so I should hear it a total of 8 times now. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Awesome. What if I had done this? What if I repeated the outside 4 times and the inside 2 times? How many times do you think it would repeat now? Let's listen. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Pretty cool. What if on the inside I repeated this 0 times? Do you remember what happened last time when we repeated something 0 times? Let me double click on this and we'll see if it makes any noise. Doesn't make any noise. So now what's going to happen if I repeat that inside part that doesn't make any noise 4 times? It also doesn't make any noise. What if I repeat this 1 time on the inside? How many times should I hear it? Let's listen. 2, 3, 4. Cool. What about if I put the 0 on the outside? Now I'll repeat everything on the inside here 0 times. Should I hear anything? What do you think? I double clicked on it and I don't hear anything. Are you noticing a pattern? What if I put 3 on the outside and 4 on the inside? I can think about this as 3 times 4, and so this inside part will play 12 times. Or if I had 5 on the outside and 3 on the inside will play 3 times, and I'll do that 5 times, so that's like 5 times 3, and it'll play 15 times.